Welcome to Artistic Designs by M&M. I'm Michelle with Artistics. I'm an independent designer with Chalk Couture. I am going to do a season harvest turkey today for you. So here it is for you. So it says season harvest, turkey grains, more gobble, less wobble. And I am going to do it on this little board. So it's kind of like a, it's not quite a shadow box, but it's just like a, looks like a tray in a way with little handles, like right here. And I thought it would be cute on this board. So I have a few colors already picked out. Let me go ahead and switch over so that way you can see my view on the table. So I have orange. I have some red. I have some green, which is actually called meadow. My red is actually candy apple. I have black. And then I have iced coffee, which is kind of like a brown. I was thinking of doing the iced coffee, orange, and the red together for the turkey. And then doing the green for some of the words and the black for some of the words. So we'll see how it goes. So I have my transfer, which as you can tell, this is a silk screen transfer. Alright. So this is called a silk screen transfer, meaning that it is reusable. It's not like the regular stencils. There's a screen and then there's the design, which is like a mesh where it's at. So it's allows you to be able to reuse this silk screen up to 8 to 12 times depending on how you use it and how you take care of your transfer. So as long as you take good care of your transfer, the longer it will last. Alright, so the first thing I want to do is I want to mark my transfer. I want to mark it on the back so that way I know which side's the back, because I have a side that I want to be able to stick my turkey on, but I also have a side that I don't want to stick it on. So I'm just going to put turkey on this side so that way I know I'm not sticking my turkey on this side. And then this is just like a little side design. So let's see. I don't know what to call it. I'm just going to put turkey design. I'm not really good at what things are called. So, who knows? Alright. Next, what I'm going to do is you just want to rub your finger on this over the corner, the edge, and it will peel off. And you just want to, so let me move the box over so you can see what I'm doing. You just want to peel the back off. You could probably hear my dog. He's kind of, that's Oscar. I've shown you a picture on my Facebook of what he looks like. He's my little chalking buddy. Right now he's not sitting on the floor. He's busy barking at something. So first, I want to use my towel. I want to fuzz my transfer, especially since this is not a Chalk Couture surface. This is more of a wood surface. I am going to want to make sure that this is really fuzzed, so that way my transfer does not stick to it. Because if it sticks to it, it's going to pull up some of that wood. It may become really hard to pull up my transfer, and then I could ruin my transfer at the same time, and I don't want to do that, so I want to be really, really careful with that. I want it to stick, but I don't want it to stick so much that I have a hard time getting it off. So there we go. So once I'm done, I can set my towel aside. And I'm going to put this right in the center because I want those outer designs for the, or the, these designs right here to go on the outside. Which I have not totally decided what color I want those in. So, we'll see when it comes to it. And then you just want to make sure that you don't get stuff into your transfer, or into the, so the colored part is fine. You just don't want to get it into the actual design. And that one was kind of coming close. I had picked up a little piece of the wood. So then you're just going to press down wherever the design is along the thing. So you just want to make sure it's centered as best as you can. Which I think it's going to be, let's see. I think it's pretty centered as best as it's going to be. Sometimes you can't get it totally centered. Just get it centered as best as you can. All right, so what do I want? I want to do my words. I think I'm going to do this one green. So I'm just going to use, this one's a small squeegee that I had gotten, but I cut it into in half so that way I would have two pieces, so that way it gave me more more to work with, you know, two pieces to work with. So I have already stirred up my paste. This is Choc Couture paste. You want it to be just kind of, I want it to be loose. It also dries really fast, and so you want it to be loose so that way it will be workable and won't dry out on you, on your surface too fast. And we are going to do a, I am going to do a paste and peel because it works better for me when I'm doing multiple colors and doing a surface like this. Just because if I don't, then it dries too fast on me and it will start peeling up the chalk and the design. And I don't want it to do that. I don't want it to get stuck in my transfer. So I am just going to go right across the season harvest at the top. And the nice thing about this paste is that you do not have to use very much. Just use a little bit and then squeegee off the rest. And then you can peel up. So as you can see, that's what it will end up looking like. Let me get it down a little bit. It's right there. So I'm gonna blow dry this. Low temperature, just cool setting, because I don't want it to be hot. I just want to dry it a bit so I can lay my transfer back over it. but I don't want it to be wet. And it dries, like I said, it dries pretty quickly. So it just takes a few seconds to dry it. And as you can tell, I can sit here and I can rub my finger over it and I won't have any paste on my finger. So I'm gonna put this back down, and then I am just going to make sure that the turkey is pressed down. And then there's like some spots of green right here that I want to do as green. So I am going to use, this is called washi tape. So it is going to allow me to cover up these little areas of grass. So that way I can paste it in green. So I'm just gonna cover it up here. So that's all I did, was just cover up the little greenery area so that way I can, after I do my turkey, I can do the little green grass, okay, in green. So now I am going to do three different colors for my turkey. So I have the orange, the iced coffee, and the red. All right. So I am just going to dab it around, making sure to not get it everywhere at the same time. So they call this a hot mess. Some people might know it as a tie-dye effect. Whichever way you want to call it, it's pretty much the same thing. It's just going to mix my colors together. As long as I'm careful with how I put it on the board here, I can put whatever extra that I have on my squeegee back into my container. But if I were to accidentally mix it, then I cannot put it back into my container or into with my color. You don't want to mix your colors. All right, just kind of lift it up a bit. So I better be careful there. So I think I got it around. So you just want to look at your stick and make sure that you haven't, if you did mix it up, make sure that you got it off. Okay. And then you can just easily start spreading your color. Around. Until it is all spread out all over your turkey. So now that it is mixed, I cannot put it back in to any of my jars. If you wanted to save it, you could. It's not a whole lot, so I'm not going to worry about saving it. So I am just going to put it on a paper towel. And I am just going to squeegee up a little bit here. Make sure that it's, but I also want to make sure that it's wet in all areas, because sometimes with my hot mess, it likes to dry out really fast on me, and so then it peels up on me. So sometimes I leave it on a little bit thicker. So let's go ahead and pull that up. And you have your turkey. He looks pretty awesome. Oh, and my thing is kind of pulling up, so I'm gonna have to lay it back down.